Now I'm going to explain paints and primary colors at the molecular level. So you're probably wondering why on a paint, if you mix yellow and blue, why does it become green? Well, it has to do with the reflective properties. When you mix the paint, what is reflected changes. So we're going to come over here and I'm going to explain that at the molecular level, and you'll see it's very easy. All right, once again, what we have, red, green, and blue particles. Now, what happens on this atom? Blue bounces off, the green and red don't. What happens on the yellow? The red and the green both bounce off or are reflective. So what happens when you mix these paints? Well, you're going to have a different chemical composition. So what happens is when you mix the blue in with the yellow, what happens is it blocks the red. So if you take the red out, the red no longer is reflected. It's changed. Also, the colors in the yellow cause the blue to be reflected differently. And it causes the blue to not be reflected. So when you mix blue and yellow, what do you have left? Green. That's what's reflected in the paint color. So whenever you have your primary colors, how you mix them and how you arrange them changes the reflective property, and it also changes the color. So this example here of blue and yellow becoming green works across all the colors. You just have to see it, look at it, and say, all right, when I mix these, this color is blocking this color, and you can't see it anymore, and what is left of the particle. That's how it works. Now, so what you have to do to figure out light is you have to remember there is a direct source that has a red, green, and a blue. TV, computer screens, prove that. That's the only three colors that are coming. Your eyes have three cones, red, green, and blue. And whatever hits those is the color that your brain tells you that it sees. Reflected light is different. It reflects three different colors, red, green, and blue. And you have to remember, reflected is different than direct. And once you get the geometry correct, it's easy to understand. Why? Because physics and chemistry are easy with the correct geometry.